So today we're here with Zahid for another segment or insight. Zahid, do you think it's possible to have it all? Is there some kind of secret to getting everything that we want?
Well, I think everything is difficult, but definitely you can definitely have it. Have most of the things you really want. And one of the keys I feel is something I call sequencing. And I don't want to lie. My cousin coined the term sequencing. Now, I don't know if he meant exactly the way I interpreted it, but when I heard it, I'm like, what a beautiful saying. So what is sequencing? Sequencing is a little bit different than prioritizing. I think everyone can understand prioritizing. I have my kids, I have my job, I have this and this and this. And they make sure that they do all the things that are, you know, highest to lowest importance, right? So prioritizing is a very common thing. I like to go a little bit further, which is, it's called sequencing. It's a little bit like prioritizing, but it's like on steroids. I believe everything has an opportunity window, right? So what I mean by that is, you know, I want to get my mortgage application done today, right? And I also want to, you know, make my report that's due, tomorrow. And I have a couple of meetings with some of my staff members because they're working on a project that's due at the end of the week. And, you know, so you have like a bunch of things that are important, but I try to identify what is the opportunity window. So for example, if I want to get an approval for my mortgage, I have to, you know, submit my paperwork by today. So that way my mortgage broker, my mortgage agent could have enough time to prepare it because he said he needs 2 or 3 business days, he or she. So I try to make a mental list of all of the things that have a kind of a opportunity window, a window of opportunity, where if I don't capitalize it at that time, meaning if I do it like an hour later or 5 minutes later, I miss that opportunity for the day, right? So for example, it could be like going to the bank, right? Where you can shoot, the bank is closed by 4 o'clock today. And if I don't go to the bank, I could choose to go to the bank at 3:30 or 5:30. But if I go at 5:30, it's closed. Right. So I missed the window and now I have to wait till the next morning. Right. So I try to figure out what are all the opportunity windows that I have. Right. Whether it's to meet a deadline for work or, you know, a store is opened at a certain time or is closed at a certain time or, you know, I have to get my car fixed or whatever the things you have in your life. You have to understand when is that like that window of opportunity closing on you. You know, if you miss that opportunity, you're essentially pushing it off till the next day, right? Because sometimes I see a staff member, they're working on something and they ask me, can I get to you at the end of the day? I'm like, well, if you have it done now, you can give this to like these 4 other staff members and they can kind of rock and roll the whole day. Right. Whereas you spend the same 10 minutes at the end of the day, they've already gone for the day. So you just missed one day of opportunity times 4 people, right? So that's what I mean by opportunity window. Is to really understand what is the opportunity window of a said task or of a said goal and make sure you capitalize on it, right? And I think that's one of the key ingredients of sequencing. Do you guys sequence at all? Or are you more like prioritizing and just doing something like, this is my project, I'm working on this for the next like 4 hours or my next 4 days, and I'm not gonna do anything else until I finish this?
No, because of the nature of what I do, it's constantly, in answer to other people's timelines, clients' timelines. So, you know, it's almost like forced prioritizing.
So I like that example because you probably do it all the time, right? And you're really good at it and you probably don't notice it. Mm-hmm. So you mentioned a client's timeline, right? That's a great example for sequencing. So this, one of the key points of the sequencing is scattered work, mm-hmm. right? So some people don't like scattered work. Like they don't want to do something for 10 minutes, do this for an hour, stop that, and then do this for half an hour, stop that. And, you know, they'd rather just like, you know what, for the next 8 hours, I'm going to only work on so-and-so, right? So you said, well, you don't really have that luxury because maybe a client's waiting for you or they're going to call you. Right. You know they're going to call you at 12 because they always call you at 12. And you told them yesterday that, okay, I'll have something for you by tomorrow, right? And you know they're going to be calling. So you have a little opportunity window. So you're kind of forcing yourself that, you know what, I want to be a professional, so I don't want them to call and say I have no updates, right? So you might have to do the minimum, like 10 minutes of opening a document or something, so when they call you, you were able to give them something.
That's right.
And as soon as you do that, what it allows you to do is buy some more time, right? Or you know, earn some credibility, right? Because you said, I'll have something for you by tomorrow. And sure enough, when they called you, it's like, yep, Mr. So-and-so or Mrs. So-and-so, yes, I have this done. Or, you know, I looked into it and it looks like it's going to take me 3 days and I should have an answer, whatever, right? So at least you're kind of continuing to move, yeah, right? And that's very, very important for sequencing, right? And I think that's the key thing. People, it's not convenient. It's not fun to have to kind of switch gears like 10 times in an hour sometimes, right? But sometimes if you could do it, all of a sudden you might have hit like all these opportunity windows that allow many, many, many things to kind of keep moving.
Yes, that's right.
Last thing about sequencing is progress over perfection. Sometimes, you know, I ask a staff member, can you have this done? And they're like, I'll have all of this done for you on Friday, right? Then I say, well, you know what? I'd rather have you give me 50% or 20% today, right? Because it allows that 20% allows me to hand off different things, right? You give me 100% on Friday, basically everyone's waiting, or like people can't work on that project until Friday, right? So I'd rather you give me 20% today,
exactly,
or 20% every day, and or maybe 20% today, because that's all I need for these three people to move.
Yes.
And then you can take the rest of the week to give me the other 80%. But just having that 20% allows me to coordinate that much more effectively when I have that. So could you have it all, Keisha? I think if you can sequence, I think it allows you to have so many more things.